Hello there, fellow model makers, and welcome to the third part of my Tamiya 148 scale Spitfire Mark 1 build. This is where we left off last time. The building part is largely done, and we have primed the aircraft black. I am now ready to start painting this bird, and I thought I would try something new here. I am going to mask some of the panels and paint them brown, in the hope that the brown would show through and give the paint job more tonal variation. The plan, however, did not work. But still, nothing ventured, nothing gained. I now start marbling the plane with mixed satin white. As you can see, I had initially not marbled the panels painted brown. I suspect this was the right thing to do if I wanted the brown to show through the subsequent paint. However, after a while, I decided to marble the brown panels as well. This reduced the amount of brown paint showing through considerably, and in the end, much of the effect was lost once more paint layers were added. In retrospect, even if I had wanted to marble these brown panels, I should have used a different color rather than going with the white. I guess a lighter shade of brown should have been used. It's something to keep in mind for next time. The underside is painted with XF21 Sky, as indicated in the instructions. Let's not forget to paint the few bits that have not been glued to the aircraft yet. Once the sky paint was dry, it was time to mask it off. With the masking complete, I cleaned up the sky paint that had spilled over the top side with some black. I now add some marbling with white once again. This time, I decided to marble a few random panels with brown. This approach did work, but success was limited. The panel variation did show through under the green parts of the kit, but obviously did not really show through where the brown camo paint went on. In the end, there was really very little to tell the white marbling apart from the brown marbling. The instructions call for mixing these two colors, XF61 dark green and XF62 olive drab, in 1:4 ratio, if I remember correctly. As you can see, the brown mottling is showing through the green paint. But in all honesty, with subsequent paint layers, the effect became less and less noticeable, till in the end, you could only see it if you knew it was there and were looking for it. Perhaps a lighter brown may have done the trick. I now use MIG masking putty to outline the camo pattern painted green. For the brown part of the camo scheme, the instructions call for mixing XF52 flat earth and XF49 khaki in 4:1 ratio. When I removed the masking putty, I found that some of the brown had sprayed over the green section. This is not really a huge problem, as I was able to fix it easily by going over the green sections once again. What concerned me more was that I did not really like the sharp edge on the camo scheme. Somehow it did not feel right. So using my creative license, which some of you may have noticed I use quite liberally, I feathered the edges on the camo scheme. I like this look better than the sharp-edged camo scheme and decided to go with it. A coat of gloss varnish really brings out the colors, giving them a deeper hue. With the basic paint job done, I attached the wheel assembly to the kit. Tamiya have molded the landing gear assembly in one piece. Once again, this helps with the alignment of the piece at the correct angle. Also, the wheel assembly is much sturdier this way, as compared to individual struts that tend to move about. With all the pieces in place and the coat of gloss varnish dry, it was time to apply the decals, which I did using Microset and Sol. I had to be patient with the decals, as it took several applications of Microsol to get them to conform properly. But they did conform pretty well in the end. I just helped the decals along by gently running a cocktail stick along the panel lines and rubbing the decal with a Q-tip. The side markings are rather large on this plane, and the decals have a lot of extra film. So I took a pair of scissors and cut the film as close to the letters as possible. This did make the decals a little harder to fix, but in the end, I was happy that I was able to get rid of most of the extra film. Once the decals had conformed to my liking and dried, I sealed them up with another layer of gloss varnish. Right then, fellow model makers, the paint job is done and it's time to start weathering the kit. However, that will have to wait till the fourth and last edition of this video series. I hope you are enjoying the build and the videos. Please do subscribe to the channel and leave a like. Till next time, good luck and happy model making.